Noble Spouse Yogis, congratulations, you guys have made it to day six. And I think Sheree and I were both in the same frame of mind when we were thinking that you needed a couple of days of a little bit of an easier workout, a little bit more relaxation. So today we're going to get ourselves in a black cat state of mind. And as most people know, nobody relaxes or takes it easy better than a cat. So with that in mind, we are going to do some deep stretches and some deep breathing and find ourselves in a hopefully total state of relaxation. So, as a forewarning, you might want to do this before you go to bed because you might not be too productive the rest of your day because you're just going to be feeling so relaxed. All right, so to begin with today, we are going to go ahead, get some music going here, and start out laying all the way down flat in corpse pose. So I want you to lay here for a moment. Close your eyes. You can let your hands and your feet roll to the sides of your mat. We're just going to take a few moments while we're here to take some deep breaths. Inhale. Start to feel your breath go beyond your chest and all the way down into your belly. Alright, now I want you to take your right leg. At the knee, take it all the way to your chest, give it a little hug. Throughout this whole practice today, I want you to be extra aware of your breathing. Okay, let's lower that leg down and bring our other leg up and give it a little hug. Just a little hug, you don't have to squeeze it too tight. Feet down onto our mat, hands down, palms flat, and we're going to slowly release our tailbone off the ground. We'll just hold here for a moment. If you need to adjust a little bit, maybe pull your feet a little bit closer to your body. And again, deeply inhale. Hold here for a few breaths. And slowly lower your tailbone back down onto the mat. From here, we're going to take our hands, place them behind your head. We're going to one leg down, and one leg up. This is almost a bicycle. So we're gonna raise up and touch your elbow to your knee. And then we're gonna switch sides. Sorry, I'm going the wrong way there. And just slowly alternate from side to side. While you're doing this, I want you to be using your core. So don't be pulling yourself up with your hands. Use your core to lift off the ground. Let's do that two more times. Now we're going to, again, take our knees one at a time up to our chest. Let's take your right leg and your knee up. Give it a little hug. And then we're going to release that to the mat. And take slowly sit up. We're going to reverse our position. And we're going to find ourselves in tabletop. So in tabletop, check in. Hands are under your elbows, under your shoulders, and your knees are under your hips. Fingers spread wide, pressing into your mat. Take a moment here. Now we're going to go to our black cat flow. So take your head, slowly roll it down towards your chest, chin towards heart center, and back rounding up. And then we're going to reverse that. So head and chest up, tailbone up, and your belly towards your mat. Just take your time. Slowly flow between cat and cow. And I might look like the girl from The Ring here with this hair in my face. Make sure that you are inhaling and exhaling with each move. Also be aware of the really nice stretch that you should be getting in your lower back right now. All right, so whenever you're ready, go ahead and meet me back in tabletop. Take a moment again to check in with your alignment. Hands under your shoulders, fingers spread wide. And we're going to find some spinal balance. So take your left leg and reach it out, pressing that imaginary wall behind you with the sole of your foot. We're just going to hold it here for a moment. And then we're going to take our right arm and reach it out in front of us. Just imagine your body lengthening and stretching. Okay, and slowly lower it down, and we're going to switch sides. So take your right leg out, pressing against that imaginary wall behind you, and your left arm in front of you. And of course, again, just be aware of that lengthening and stretching through your entire body. Slowly lower it back down, and now we're going to flow. So at your own pace, switching sides. And just make sure that you are breathing. Deeply inhaling and exhaling with each movement. Just a couple more times. Back in tabletop. We're going to slowly lower ourselves and push all the way back into child's pose. And as always, it's up to you whether you want to have your hands behind you or in front of you for a little extra stretch. You can also take your knees to the edge of your mat and create just a little bit more room for your body. So let's take a moment here to find our breath. And again, I want you to notice as you inhale, not only are you filling up your chest, but you're filling up your whole belly. Thank you. slowly push all the way back up again. Now we're going to raise up on our knees. And while you're here, let's go ahead and give our feet a little bit of love. So curl your toes under and just sit back on those feet. While we're here, we're going to work on a little bit of a shoulder stretch. So grasp each of your elbows. And we're going to just very gently twist to the side. Not only does this stretch your shoulders, but it's kind of a full side stretch for you. Then meet me back at center. Now we're going to put the tops of our feet back flat on our mats. Rise all the way up on our knees. Check in again right now. Make sure your shoulders are down and back. Navel towards your spine. And from here, imagine that somebody has a rope tied to the top of your head and they're just pulling it straight up. So you should feel your spinal alignment and just your whole body elongating right out of the top of your head, right? So go ahead and take your hands, make them into fists, place them on the small of your back, and now with each deep breath, I want you to just slowly raise your head, raise your chest, and lower yourself back into a back bend. I only want you to go as far back as you are comfortable. So if that means staying straight up like this, that is great. Or if it means with your hands all the way down, touching the ground, do what feels best for your own body. All right. I'm gonna take a moment here. Take a few deep breaths. Start to feel kind of a burning, tingling sensation in your lower back. One more deep breath. And then let yourself slowly raise up. Keep your fists back. Give yourself just a little massage in your lower back. All right, now release your hands forward. We're going to give our necks and our shoulders a little more love. So I want you to go ahead and just slowly take your shoulders down. All right, and now we're going to give our neck love. So let's take our head, slowly move it from side to side. Up and down. Now I want you to imagine that you're drawing circles in the sky in front of you with your nose. So all the way around. And then switch sides. And if you want, you can switch sides again. side to side one more time. Alright, so from here we're going to slowly lower ourselves down into a seated position on our mats. Take our soles of our feet together and we're going to find ourselves in butterfly. So if you need to adjust your seat so that you're comfortable, we'll take both of our elbows and you press them against your knees or your thighs. And then I want you to grab onto your ankles. I want you to press down with your arms while you are pressing up with your legs. And you will be creating a tension there. You should start to feel a stretch on your inner thighs. And also, you should start to feel a stretch in your shoulders. Depending on just how hard you are pressing up with your legs and down with your arms. Here and take a few more deep breaths. And then we're going to lower our left leg out in front of us straight. And your right leg is going to be up. Take your right hand, place it to your side. Left hand is going to come over to meet it. And we're going to give ourselves a little bit of a twist. Now don't force it. Just slowly allow yourself to twist. And stop as soon as your body is telling you to stop. You don't want to push it too far. And while you're here, I want you to breathe deeply. And then we're going to rotate forward. We're going to switch sides. So your right leg goes all the way down and straight in front of you. Left leg comes up. And then slowly take your hands to the side. Just feel that nice twist and stretch. And again, we're going to take a few deep breaths here. Leg down, and now we're going to take both legs out into a straddle. So from here, I want you to place your hands in front of you, and with each deep breath, just allow yourself to sink a little bit further towards the ground. And as we've told you before, the goal is not the ground. The goal is wherever your body is telling you is the best spot for you. So when you feel like it's yelling at you, stop, then stop. You will still be getting a great stretch no matter how far down you are on your mat. And trust me, you'll know, because your thighs will be screaming at you, stop, if you're going a little bit too far. Guys, you're doing great. Let's take three more deep breaths. All right. Bring yourself all the way up to seated. We're going to take our legs all the way in front of us onto our mats. And we're going to go ahead and lay flat. You can keep your knees up. We're going to lay them all the way down to one side. Take your arms out. We're going to give ourselves another little twist here. And if you'd like, you can have one leg straight, one leg over. Just so that you're feeling the stretch and the twist. in with this twist. Don't force it. Only twist and go as far as you are feeling comfortable. Alright, let's go back to center. We're going to take one leg at a time here. Give it another little hug. Let's take your right leg to your chest. Your left leg flat down on the mat. Just give it a little hug. And then we'll switch sides. Right leg goes flat on the mat. Left leg comes up. Give it a little hug. Make sure that you are inhaling and exhaling. And then we're going to bring both legs up. And while we're here, if you want to interlace your fingers, you want to just hold on. Let's gently rock back and forth. Probably not a move you're going to see a cat doing anytime soon, but it definitely feels good. Slowly lower our feet back down onto the mats. We're going to take the soles of our feet together. Let your legs just lay down as far as they'll go to the sides. And you can take your arms out to your sides. Palms up if you wish. Or you can even keep them at heart center. This is another good move for your hips, and it stretches your thighs, so you should start to feel kind of the burning again. Just let your legs go down as far as they want. For some of you who are a little bit more bendy, your legs might be touching the ground, but as you can see, I'm not as bendy, so mine are just going to hang there. And while you're here, I want you to close your eyes. When you inhale, I want you to inhale through your nose. But when you exhale, let it go through your mouth. Deep inhale through your nose. Deep exhale through your mouth. Let's do that two more times. Bring our legs all the way back up to center. And now, everybody's favorite part of yoga. We're going to take a little cat nap if you wish. So lay your legs all the way down flat on your mat. Let your feet roll to the sides. That means rolling all the way off your mat, wherever you feel the most relaxed and comfortable. Same with your hands. Down at your sides, but let them roll off your mat. You should definitely have your eyes closed. Just adjust however you need to, so that you are in your most comfortable spot. every hair, every whisker is completely relaxed. As you look at that cat, he almost looks as though he's kind of melting and just becoming a part of whatever he is laying on. Laying there without a care in the world. Guys, it's time to slowly wake our bodies up from our cat nap. So I want you to wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. I want you to take your arms up over your head. Just give yourselves one last nice stretch. One big full body stretch. Already, you can open your eyes. And whenever you're ready, we're going to slowly sit back up on our mats. I want to thank you guys for sticking with us. Sheree and I are just amazed at all the people that are participating, and we love it. So, you finished day 6, and hopefully you're feeling relaxed and rejuvenated.